गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
अदर्स डोंट नो गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
सो आई हैव टू कॉल ईच वन ऑफ यू टू गेट ए गुड। ओके चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर new chapter, our third chapter, pair of linear equation in two variable. Okay, did you get your graph book from the school? Did you get your graph books?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so for the next class you should be ready with your graph book. Okay, so our new chapter, chapter 3. Chapter 3, pair of linear equations in two variable. Pair of linear equations in two variables. Pair of linear equations in two variables. Chapter 3, pair of linear equations in two variable. What do you mean by a linear equation in two variable? Anybody give an example for linear equation in two variable? Example for linear equation in two variable. Anybody?
Five x plus 3x minus 3.
No, 5x plus 3x, there is only one variable x. Two variables.
And so 5x Karthik, plus 3y.
Equation. So 5x plus 3y. To become an equation, we need equal to something. So 5x plus 3y equal to 5, or 5x plus 3y equal to 7, or 5x plus 3y equal to 0. So this is the form of a linear equation in two variables. You can say 2x minus y equal to 1, 5x plus 3y equal to 2. All these are linear equation in two variables. Why these equations are linear? Their degrees are 1. Degree of the variables are 1. So they are called a linear equation. Linear equation in two variables. There are two variables like x and y, or p and q, or s and t. Any variable we can, usually we will give x and y. So these all are linear equations in two variables. So pair of linear equation in two variables, how many will be there? Pair means how many equations will be there in a pair?
Double.
Two equations. Though these two combined, we can say a pair of linear equation in two variable. Or 5x minus 2y equal to 7, 12x plus, or it's 12x minus y equal to 1. This is a pair of linear equation in two variable. Here the variables are x and y. Okay. And last year you have studied graph of a linear equation. What is the shape of graph of a linear equation? Shape of graph of a linear equation. You have studied to draw the graph of linear equation. What is the shape?
Straight line.
Straight line. A linear equation is represented by a straight line. Okay. So a pair of linear equation means there will be two linear equations. That pair we can consider this pair as a system of linear equation. A system of pair of linear equation means there must be two linear equations in with the two variables. Like 5x minus 2y equal to 7, 12x minus y equal to 1, it is a pair of linear equation in two variable, or a system of linear equation in two variable. Okay, so first of all we will write the general form of a pair of linear equation in two variable. the general form of a pair of linear equation in two variable. In two variable, the general form of a pair of linear equation in two variable. Variable is, it is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, where a1, b1, c1, A2, B2, C2 are real numbers. These are the real numbers. A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are the real numbers. A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0. A2x plus B2y plus C2 equal to 0. This is the general form of a pair of linear equation. Anjali, what is the general form of a pair of linear equation, Anjali?
A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0. Mm-hmm. A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0.
Dominic, what is the general form of pair of linear equation in two variable, Dominic? Dominic, unmute and say, what is the general form of linear equation in two variable, Dominic? Revu?
A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0. A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0.
Okay, Dominic, say what is the general form of a pair of linear equation in two variable? Dominic, your video has no problem, so you can say it. Your connectivity is okay. Read, Dominic. Why you are not responding, Dominic? Dominic, can you hear me? If you can't respond, you please send a message. Can you hear me or not, Dominic? Okay, you won't respond. The general form of a pair of linear equation is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, where a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are real numbers. And we know that the graph of a linear equation is a straight line, that you know. It's a straight line. Okay. So last year you have drawn the graph of a linear equation on graph papers and you found it is a straight line. Okay. In here we have two linear equations. Okay. A pair of linear equation or a system of linear equation contains here two linear equations. So when we draw the graph of a pair of linear equation, how many straight lines will be there on the graph? Melita, if we draw a pair of linear equations on a on graph, on same graph, how many straight lines will be there on the graph paper? The graph of a linear equation is a straight line. And last year you have studied how to draw the graph of a linear equation. You have drawn and you got it as straight line. Here we are drawing a pair of linear equation on a same graph paper. So how many graphs, straight lines, how many straight lines will be there on that graph?
Two.
Gaudi?
Two.
Two, because first one will represent a straight line. Second one also will represent a straight line. Two straight lines will be there on the graph paper. So that graph lines may be like this. One is one, this way, this way. So they may be intersecting. They may be intersect at a point. Or what, Saith? They can be intersecting. Or they can be, Karthik? They can be intersect. They will cross each other. Or they can be, or they can be, think they all of you, or they can be just in
complement.
Louder. They can
complement.
Be
they can form a complement angles between
angle. How? Two lines. So all of you try to draw in your book two lines. One possibility is they will cross each other. Or, so well, Justin, what is the next possibility? This way they can cross each other. That is a possibility if we draw two lines. Or what is the next possibility? Think.
Parallel lines.
Yes, good. They can be parallel. Sometimes they won't cross each other. They will be parallel. They won't cross each other. They will go parallelly. They will be parallel. Or one more chance is there. Or what can be when we draw two lines? They can be cross sometimes. They can be parallel. Or one more chance. What it will be? So if you try draw small lines in your book, then what can be? They can cross, they can be parallel, or when you are drawing a line using a scale and pencil, you draw a line and you think it was not darkened. So what we will, you will draw one more line. So what is happening there? Using a scale while drawing a line, you will draw one line. If it is not darkened, what you will do? What you will do? You will draw one more line, isn't it? Usually we are doing that while drawing margin. You will draw one line and you will draw one more line on the same to darken that one, isn't it? Usually you will do that process, isn't it? So what is happening? You are drawing two or three lines on the same. So the lines, all those are different lines, isn't it? Using a scale, suppose you are putting a scale on your book and you draw a line again and again for darkening, you are drawing again and again on the same line. So what is happening? You are drawing different lines on the same place. So those lines are coinciding one upon another. The lines are coinciding. I draw a line here. Line say line L. Again, line M I draw again on the same L. Line N. All these lines are coinciding. The very good example is while we are drawing a margin using a scale and pencil, after drawing one line, for darkening that line, we are again and again drawing on that line, isn't it? You didn't do that?
Yes, ma'am.
You have never did that process? You did or not that? Usually we will do. Usually we will draw again and again on the same line. Then what is happening there? The lines are coinciding one upon another, one upon another. The lines are coinciding. So these are the three possibilities when we draw two lines on a plane or in a graph paper or in a paper. What is happening? They may be either intersecting. The lines can be intersecting lines. Intersecting. Intersecting lines or parallel lines. Parallel lines or coinciding lines. Coinciding lines, that is one upon another line. Okay, so when we draw a pair of linear equation on a graph paper, the graph or the lines are straight lines. They may be intersecting lines, coinciding lines or parallel lines. These are the three possibilities when we draw lines on a graph paper or pair of linear equation on a graph paper. Okay. So you write. After writing the general form of a linear equation, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y equal to 0. Then after that, you write, if we represent a pair of linear equation, if we represent a pair of linear equation, a pair of linear equations on a graph, the lines will be a straight line, that we know. Linear equation represented by straight line. They can be, first one, intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. Second one, coinciding lines, that is one line lie upon another line. One line lie upon another line. Third one, parallel lines. Third one, parallel lines. So these are the three possibilities when we draw graph of a pair of linear equation on a graph. So we can represent intersecting lines. Lines can be intersecting. This is line M, intersecting. Intersecting lines. Coinciding lines. LM. Coinciding lines. Third one, parallel lines. LM. Draw this three, intersecting lines, coinciding lines, and parallel lines. Next solution of this right solution. What is solution of a pair of linear equation? Solution means the pair of linear equations are a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0 is the solution. Okay. Solution means it is the value of x and y. Solution means it is the values of x and y which satisfies both the equation. Solution of a pair of linear equation means it is the values of x and y. It may be x equal to 2, y equal to negative 1. And if you substitute x equal to 2 in both the equation and y equal to negative 1 in both the equation, we will get right side equal to 0. In both the cases, we can say that x equal to 1 and y equal to 2 are the solution. So solution of a pair of linear equation is the values of x and y which satisfies both the equations. Okay. So the solution of a pair of linear equation is the values of equation R are the values of x and y which satisfies both the equations. In a pair of linear equation, there will be two linear equations. Solution means the values of x and y, which satisfies both the equations. They are known as a pair of linear equation. A pair of linear equation is represented by a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. They are this pair of linear equation in two variable, and their solution means they are the values of x and y which satisfies both the equation. And when we draw these lines on a graph, they can be intersecting, coinciding, or parallel. Now, this pair of linear equation, they are a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. They are of two types. A pair of linear equations are of two types. One is consistent system of linear equation. Second one is inconsistent system of linear equation. Okay, so write consistent system of linear equation. Consistent system of linear equation means if the given set of equation or given pair of equation has at least one solution. Solution we studied. Solution is the values of x and y which satisfies the equations. So consistent pair of linear equation means that pair have at least one solution. Then that pair is known as consistent pair of linear equation. So consistent pair of linear equation is a linear equation which have at least one solution. At least one. Or we can have more. Okay. So write. A system of linear equation is said to be consistent. Is said to be consistent if it has at least one solution. it has at least one solution. If it has at least one solution, that is x equal to some value, y equal to 1, x equal to 2, y equal to 3. It's one solution. At least one solution, that system is called consistent. So inconsistent means the system has no solution. Okay, so inconsistent system. Inconsistent system of linear equation. Next one is inconsistent. Inconsistent system of linear equation. A system of linear equation is said to be inconsistent. A system of linear equation is said to be inconsistent. Said to be inconsistent if it has no solution. So what we have discussed up to this, we discussed about a pair of linear equation or a system of linear equation. A pair of linear equation is represented by, how can we represent, Sania? General form, pair of linear equations, general form?
A1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. A2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0.
This is known as a pair of linear equation. This pair of linear equation, the graph of these linear equations are three type. Which are they, Gerlin? Which are they?
Intersecting line, parallel line, coinciding line.
Coinciding lines, intersecting lines, parallel lines and coinciding lines. And the system has two types. The system of linear equation has two types. One is consistent, other one is inconsistent. Gautam, what do you mean by consistent? Gautam?
A system of linear equation is said to be consistent if it has at least one solution.
Justin, what do you mean by inconsistent system?
System of linear equation is said to be inconsistent if it has no solution.
Syed, what is meaning of solution? Syed? What is the meaning of solution?
Solution means A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0.
So what is the meaning of solution? It is a system of equation, pair of equation. Then what is its solution means? Solution. Abin Thompson, solution means?
Solution of a pair of linear equations are the value of x and y, which satisfies both the equations.
Yeah, both the equations. Okay. Now, we will, using the graph, we can predict how many solutions we'll have for a pair of linear equations. Okay. And we discussed that the pair of linear equations are represented by three types of graphs. They are intersecting, other one is parallel, parallel and coinciding and parallel. L, M. These are the three types of when we draw the graph of a pair of linear equation. If the lines are, listen to the board, very important it is, if the lines are intersecting, they meet at a point, isn't it? If the lines L and M are intersecting and they meet at a point, if the graph is of this type, that is intersecting solution, then we can say that that system of equation or that pair of equation has only one zero or a unique solution. Unique solution, only one solution. If the lines are intersecting, the system of equation has only one solution or unique solution. Okay. Then second one, if the lines are coinciding, here it is intersecting. Intersecting lines. Here coinciding. Coinciding lines, one upon another one. Coinciding lines. In on coincide, for the case of coinciding lines, the lines are intersecting at each and every point. The lines are intersecting at each and every point, one upon a line. So at each and every point, the lines are intersecting, isn't it? So it has infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions. It has infinitely many solutions. And if lines are parallel, they are not intersecting at all. So the lines are parallel. Parallel lines. The lines are parallel. It has no solution. It has no solution. Okay. The lines are intersecting. It has unique solution. If lines are coinciding, infinitely many solutions. If the lines are parallel, no solution. So this is the geometrical interpretation of pair of linear equation in two variables. So write the heading, geometrical interpretation of a pair of linear equation. Pair of linear equation in two variable. The lines are intersecting. If the lines are intersecting, draw two intersecting lines. It has a unique solution, right? If the lines are coinciding, both L and M, the coinciding lines. Infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions. If they are parallel lines. There's no solution. Parallel lines, then they have no solution. Then they have no solution. So Minha, if two lines are intersecting, how many solutions that system has?
One solution.
One solution. Devasena, if lines are coinciding, the system has how many solutions? If the system is coinciding lines, represented by coinciding lines, how many solution? Devasena. How many solutions, Devasena? If the lines are coinciding, how many solutions, Srihari?
Infinitely many solutions.
Melita, if the lines are parallel, how many solution?
No solution.
No solution. Now, Adulya, what do you mean by a consistent system of linear equation? What do you mean by consistent system of linear equation, Adulya?
A system of linear equation is said to be consistent if it has at least one solution.
One solution. If it has at least one solution, those system has known as are known as consistent. Here, which of them are consistent? Here we have three types: intersecting, coinciding, parallel. A system has at least one solution. We can say that they are consistent. Here, which are they consistent? Which are consistent here?
Intersecting and coinciding.
Intersecting. Good. Very good. Intersecting and coinciding. Because intersecting lines has unique solution. Coinciding lines has infinitely many solution. So the first two are consistent. If the lines has unique solution, system has unique solution and infinitely many solution, then we can say that the system is consistent. The graphs represented by intersecting or coinciding, that in such cases we can say that the lines are the system is consistent. System is consistent. What about if the parallel lines? They are, the system is parallel lines, the system is
inconsistent.
In the case of parallel lines, the system is inconsistent. So here, intersecting lines and coinciding lines, the lines are, the system is consistent. Here it is inconsistent. Here it is consistent. Consistent, here it is inconsistent. Inconsistent system of equation, there is no solution. But for consistent system of equations, we have solution. Okay, so we will write, we have pair of linear equation. Pair of linear equation, pair of linear equation represented by a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, and it has two types, consistent and inconsistent. Consistent here, inconsistent. Consistent and inconsistent. Here, consistent, we have intersecting lines. Intersecting lines and coinciding lines. Coinciding lines. Here it is parallel lines. Here it is parallel lines, and intersecting lines has unique solution. Here, infinitely many solution. And here for parallel lines, no solution. over. All of you wrote this. Can I move to the next step? Sriram, Emrin, Bastin, Elsa. Wrote all of you? Did you write or not? Gerlin, did you write?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me see. Gerlin, let me see your book. Gerlin, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Now let me see. Show your book. And read. I can't see that. Read whatever you have written. Read. Let show your book, that tree I have drawn. Is there? The finally I have written. Read the last page. Read. Unmute.
Pair of linear equation divided into two types, constant system and inconsistent system. Constant system is divided into two types, intersecting lines and parallel coinciding lines. Inconsistent system is divided into parallel lines and intersecting lines is unique solution and coinciding lines infinitely many solution and parallel lines no solution.
Saeed, did you write this?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
all of you? Over?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, so we have studied how the, by seeing a graph, we can say how many solution it has, or they are either consistent or inconsistent. Okay. Now, condition for this consistency and inconsistency with the help of coefficients. Okay. Condition for consistency or inconsistency with the help of the coefficients of the equations. Okay. So let us consider. Listen to the board. Consider a pair of linear equation a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This is a pair of linear equation. Okay. Now, we know that this system can be either consistent or inconsistent. If it is consistent, they can be intersecting or coinciding. Or if it is inconsistent, the lines are parallel. And if it is parallel, no solution. If it is coinciding, infinitely many solution. If it is intersecting, it has the unique solution. Up to this, is it clear, all of you? Whenever I ask, you have to say all these things. Okay. Now, using the coefficients of x and y, we can say that whether they are consistent or inconsistent. Okay, so the first condition, if a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, if a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, we can say that the lines are intersecting. Intersecting lines. If it is intersecting, it will have unique solution. Unique solution, and hence it is consistent. consistent. So if a1 is the coefficient of x for the first one, a2 coefficient of x for the second equation, b1 coefficient of y for the first equation, b2 coefficient of y for the second equation, a1 by a2 not equal to a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. The lines are intersecting, hence they have unique solution, hence they are consistent. And second condition is, if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2, then the lines are coincident lines. Coincident lines. So infinitely many solution. Infinitely many solution. Hence, consistent or inconsistent. If it has infinitely many solution, they are consistent or inconsistent.
Consistent.
So we can say consistent. Third condition, if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2, the lines are parallel. Parallel lines. So how many solution? Parallel lines. How many solution? No solution. No solution. And lines are inconsistent. Lines are inconsistent. It's very important, it is. Yeah. All of you wrote? Gauri, what is the condition for intersecting lines?
If A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2.
By B2.
They are intersecting lines which have unique solution and they are consistent.
Very good. Lakshmi Nanda, next condition.
A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2 gives coincident line is equal to infinitely many solution.
And lines are consistent.
And their lines are consistent.
Next condition, Amarin.
A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. It's parallel. Parallel lines. No solution, inconsistent.
Inconsistent. Sean, read the first condition.
If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, they are in the setting lines, so they are unique solution and it is consistent.
Kshetra, second one.
If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2.
We will do problems based on this. The next period is 2 to 3, isn't it? That time. We will using the equations, we will find out whether the lines are coincident, parallel or intersecting, or the system is consistent or not. Okay, we will continue during that day. Okay, bye.